Guys, how you guys doing? So yeah, man. On this video here, what I'll be doing is I'll be showing you guys how to basically make that new Gqom song. You know, it's the one Gqom song that's actually gone big, and it seems like everybody's feeling it. You know, based on obviously Twitter response. But yeah, so it's a track by a lady called Babes Wodumo. So it's Babes Wodumo featuring Mampage and Destruction Boys, and it's called Wololo. Yeah, I think that's what it's called. So I'll show you guys how to make the beats of that song. You know, I did fail with a few sounds which I didn't make. I think it was I don't know if it's a trumpet or whatever. That's the only sound I struggled with, but I think the general beat and the structure of the song I sort of got, and then obviously I don't have the lyrics of the thing, so, and I mean I don't have the vocals, so yeah. So I'll just play the beat for you guys, and then yeah, I also added a few of my own sounds. But before I play the beats, I'll just explain a few things. So the kick is not, I'll just explain the instruments. The kick is just an obvious kick, nothing special about it. And then the key thing about it is this, the sound here, the high passo. I believe they use the high passo as well. I don't know how they mixed it, but yeah. It's pretty much a high passo that they use, and these are the keys for the thing, for the synth in the background. It sounds like this here. So that's the those are the keys for the synth in the background. It's not that loud, but it's there. And then you have the string. I've taught you guys how to make the string, so it's basically on C3. And then yeah, if you don't know how to make it sound like this, then go through to my video tutorial on how to make a Gqom track like Destruction Boys, and that should be able to help you. And then you have the main key thing about the beat is the snares. You know, I don't know if my snares are appropriate, but like in terms of the way they sound, they might not necessarily sound exactly the way they do on the song. But yeah, the general structure and pattern is pretty much the same. It sounds like this. So that's how that sounds, and then it looks like this here. This is how it looks. So if you want to remake it, go ahead. And then you have obviously the vocal, which sounds like this. Mine is not exactly the same. You know, I tried to mix it up with this one here as well. But yeah, I don't know which song they actually sample from. The Mampicha's voice. I don't know where they sample Mampicha's voice from, which song it was. So that's why it won't exactly sound the same as theirs. But yeah, so you have that as well, and then you have, okay, this is the same thing as the thing. And then you just have this sound there, and you have, okay, this is where I start adding my own sounds. Excuse me. So this is like sort of like my own bass that I just messed around with, and everything else is really not that important. So everything else is not part of the beat. So the beat itself, in relation to the original track, is pretty much the same up until there. Then from here onwards, I start adding my own instruments, and I just, you know, play around with it. So I'll play this out for you guys, and then let me know what you think on the comment section. And if you want the FOP, just let me know. I'll probably drop it on the thing on the website. So these are the beat sounds, guys. So that's pretty much how my one sounds, you know. Let me know what you guys think. And yeah, let me see what happens if I do this. You know, I feel like I should actually do this here when the track changes. Or maybe later on in the song. I don't know. I'm just messing around now. So what if we do this here and then we delete this one? And then it sounds more like this. So yeah, man, so that's pretty much how I made the beat. That's what it looks like, that's what it sounds like. If let me know if you're interested in the FOP. And then yeah, I'll share it on the website and then you guys can download it from there. So this is a very quick video. Yeah, just how to make that song there. It's really not that hard of a song to make. If you know how to make igqom, then you can pretty much make this song. How long did it take me? Let's see. Took me 53 minutes to just make this, you know, including the recording of the video as well and everything else. But yeah, man, otherwise, yeah, man, like, subscribe, comment, Facebook, Twitter, SoundCloud, follow all that just there. Let me know which other song you want me to try and remake. I know a lot of you guys like to request like all these hectic songs, man. Listen, I can't play like keyboards and stuff, you know. So since I can't play keyboards, I pretty much can't come up with all these 30 songs that have chords and stuff on them, because then I can't figure out the chords. So you can't really expect me to make or remake a song that's got a lot of chords and stuff, because then I won't be able to do that for you. So it's much easier for me to pretty much listen to a song and come up with the synth like I did here, because I can figure that out and then I can pretty much make the rest of the beat. But once it's got all these complex instruments, then it becomes harder for me, you know. So you can't expect me now to be able to play a saxophone so that I can remake a song for you guys, because it has a saxophone and all those things. But yeah, that's just an announcement, or not an announcement, but like something I just needed to put out there for you guys to understand. So if you do want, if you do recommend a song and I don't remake it, that means there's something about it that made me struggle to remake the song. And maybe when I did try to remake the song, it just did not sound like the way the original song sounds. So I just ended up not doing it at all, you know. So yeah, otherwise, yeah, man. Like, subscribe, comment, Facebook, Twitter, SoundCloud, follow, all that's just the shape shop of it.